Happy weekend, everybody. Tom Barnes, Chicago scene here on the west side of the city at the doorstep of the United Center for this weekend. This weekend only, you have the Windy City Smokeout. Doors are just about to open, so things are still getting put together in place here. But all weekend long, you have country music, you have barbecue food, drinks, the whole thing. It's like what summer should be. Tim McGraw is going to be here. Julia Cole, a morning show favorite, has been on the show before. She'll be here. Lots to talk about. I'm going to talk to a pitmaster, and I'm also going to talk to Callie, who will give us the rundown of this entire process. Now for the Chicago scene here, the Windy City Smokeout. All right, it's like that perfect weekend in Chicago when you combine two of your favorite things, or at least two of my favorite things. You got barbecue, music, and you are on the west side of Chicago here in the United Center parking lot. I'm here with my friend Callie at Windy City Smokeout. How are you doing?
I'm great. How are you? Beautiful day.
Right? Yeah, it's not 900 degrees. It's a little overcast, but it feels great out. It's a little bit different, right?
It does, yes.
Right before it gets warm again a little bit later on this weekend. But you guys used to be at River West location, and now you're here at the United Center on the north side of the parking lot here. But for people who have never been to the Windy City Smokeout, what is it? What should people know about it?
So really, we just try to marry all the great things about Chicago. So beautiful weather, barbecue, you know, beers flowing, and of course, country music.
Yeah, and the roster this year is pretty incredible. I mean, you have some of the biggest heavy hitters in music history. I mean, you have Tim McGraw here, among others. Can you run through some of the highlights here?
Sure. So we have Tim McGraw. He's obviously a heavy hitter, but we also have Nico Moon. He's an up-and-comer. He'll be playing on Friday. And then on Saturday, we're super excited about Jordan Davis. He always puts on a great show, and he's going to be opening up for Sam Hunt.
Yeah, and I've had Sam Hunt on the morning show a few years back, but this is more than just like what I think maybe people might think or remember if they were at the River West, just because this footprint is massive. It's huge. You have lots going on here, and you have pitmasters from all over the country. Is that right?
It is, yeah. We have 25 different teams. You know, obviously some of the greats from Chicago, including Smoke and Lily Q's, and then we've invited some new friends along. So we have Smoke Queen from LA. I'm super excited to try her food. She kind of puts an Asian spin on traditional barbecue. And then we have Wrights from Arkansas. So they're among maybe seven new teams this year, and we're thrilled to have them.
And I heard that you guys recently won Festival of the Year from CMA, which is a huge crowd. So I imagine that the crowds, especially in the country music industry, are very well aware of this festival.
Absolutely. I mean, we've grown so much in 9 years, and we're just very, very proud, and we're very humbled by the award that we won. And, you know, hopefully we can just keep this momentum going forward as we continue to kind of grow organically in Chicago here.
Absolutely. And speaking of growing organically, this the grounds are massive, right? So what are we in right now where people are kind of seeing behind you here?
So we are in Lot C of the United Center. The UC is right behind us. Yeah. And we take over about 1 million square feet between our boneyard and the festival itself and, you know, employee area, et cetera. And so, you know, they've been a great home for us.
And this specific spot we're in is just where all the pitmasters are, right?
Yes. So we're in barbecue land where all of our food takes place. And then we also have a little lifestyle area for, you know, Aperol Spritz and Kendra Scott and some of those retail items.
And that's called Rodeo Drive, right?
Rodeo Drive,
I almost said it the right way when everybody else says it the wrong way.
All day.
So again, the Rodeo Drive is what?
So it's really our lifestyle focused area. We have a bunch of different vendors there, from Verano to Tito's, Aperol, Hair Valair, and Kendra Scott.
And then you have the next spot that's beyond us here where the stage is. That's a specific name for people should know?
We just call that the entertainment part of the park.
Good, yeah.
Yeah. So that's super music focused. You know, we have live entertainment starting 1 hour after gates open. And really it's just a party from the time we open to the time we close.
Right. And you got like these spots where people can sit around the entire footprint to be able to check that out among just the people being here. But the hours, you said the live entertainment starts 1 hour after gates open. What time do the gates open on the days going forward?
Sure. So gates open at 2 p.m. Friday, 1 p.m. on Saturday and Sunday.
Awesome. And how late you guys go till?
We go till 10 p.m. every night.
That's a good run. Yeah. You got country music, food, drinks, and all that fun stuff at Rodeo Drive happening all weekend long, right?
Absolutely, yes.
And people who want tickets, if there's any available left, what's the best way for them to find that and more information about the site?
Sure. So to find more information, go to WindyCitySmokeout.com. We do have tickets available for both Friday and Sunday, but they are going quickly, so get at them.
Awesome. Well, thank you very much, Kelly. I know the gates are not open yet, but they're about to open, so you're really busy. I appreciate you taking time to chat with me, so I'll let you on your way, but thank you for chatting with me.
Absolutely. Thank you so much.
Yeah, no problem.
All right.
All right, I'm here in the backstage of the Windy City Smokeout. I'm talking to my friend Julia, who's going to perform here a little bit later on. She's been on the morning show a bunch of times, but it's about to rain, so she's in her hotel room. So, hi, Julia, how are you?
Great, how are you? Long time no see.
I know, it's been a while. It's been a hot minute since you've been at the old number 9 in our studio, but for full disclosure, people are watching this. We had you on all the time prior to the pandemic, and nothing has happened since then, but that's not technically true because you had a lot happen since then. You've blown up. Here we are, 90 million streams on streaming services. You put out new music, every week? Like, you're going nuts. And now you're going to be at Windy City Smokeout this weekend with some, like, country titans, like, Tim McGraw and others. You're going to be part of all this, doing that and a couple other fun things. What's going on?
It's pretty unbelievable the way that everything has happened this year. I got invited to make my Grand Ole Opry debut, which I did last 2 weekends ago.
Which is like a huge thing in the industry, right?
It was probably the best day of my life. And then CMT named me one of their CMT Next Women of Country Class of 2022. So I've been doing all these cool shoots, filming with CMT. My video right now is like number 5 on the CMT Hot 20 countdown, and they've got me filming 2 more segments with them for TV. It's just been crazy doing that too. And then, like you said, we're on track to hit 100 million streams in like a month.
Incredible. And you're in town. You might do a little pop-up at this event, the Windy City Smokeout, but you're doing something else there as well. So people will see you sampling the food and kind of taking in the festival, if you will.
It's pretty exciting. We're filming a television show for Circle TV, which is owned by the company that owns the Grand Ole Opry, and there's a stake ownership by NBC Universal and Gray TV. Anyway, this channel is airing a series called Circle's Ultimate Fan Fest, and I host the show going around to different music festivals in the country and showing people who weren't able to go themselves all that festival has to offer. So we're basically just
tough job.
Coolest things that you can do at Windy City Smoke. I'm going to eat all of the barbecue.
Yeah, I was told that they have something, the pitmasters there, kind of showing off their best. Not to mention that there will be drinks. Not to mention there'll be all sorts of other things. You know, there's something called Rodeo Drive where you can just sample what is there to offer, among other things. You got all the sweet things that you can buy at a fair that you're gonna be at, but it sounds like a fun job just to be able to hang out and tell people about a music festival. I mean, I kind of did that today with my segment, and I get to talk to you, so I can kind of see how this is fun.
Yeah, it's not too different, but from the advice that you've already given me, I know that I need to wear boots that are comfortable so I can walk around miles because it's huge, and show up hungry because the barbecue is incredible.
And it's going to be really hot, like 90 degrees. God. Humidity, so you're gonna have to have a lot of water if you're gonna eat all that meat, because you don't want you're gonna get the meat sweats, but it'll be okay because you're gonna have a good time.
Beer in one hand, water in the other.
Absolutely, yes. And you might have an opportunity to do a little pop-up performance here and there, so people should look out for you. I'm sure you're gonna alert your fans though on social medias as well, correct?
Absolutely. Everybody who wants the behind the scenes look and to message me, it's at Julia Cole Music on all my socials. So I actually do respond to my Instagram DMs too.
She does. I can attest for that because she answered me to talk to you about this when I heard you were going to be at Windy City Smokeout. I'm like, wow, we haven't talked in a while. So it's a perfect opportunity. So I will see you this weekend at the festival. Can't wait.
Awesome. I'll see you soon. Thank you.
All right, that's Julia Cole here at the Windy City Smokeout. Things are getting underway here. I'm gonna go find a pitmaster to talk to because you can't do barbecue without pitmaster, right? Yeah, check that out. Black's Barbecue, one of the vendors here at Windy City Smokeout. And I thought, you know what, why not talk to a pitmaster? You can't really do a segment about barbecue without talking to a pitmaster. So I'm gonna talk to my friend Barrett Black here, fourth generation pitmaster. How are you, sir?
Oh, doing excellent, man. Just so excited to be here to help celebrate our 90 years of being in business here in Chicago.
Yeah, that's amazing. And you're here at this Windy City Smokeout, which is, I think it's in the 9th year they've been doing this. But what can people find here at the booth that you guys offer up?
we brought the legends from Lockhart of what we've been doing best, that my great-grandfather started, my grandparents perfected, and now my dad, my brother, and I carrying it on. We brought the brisket, which put us on the map, and our homemade sausage that my grandfather came up with as well. On the side, we've got our buttery green beans that my grandma, of course, came up with and perfected that recipe. And we've got tons of meat in the smokers, and, you know, ready to go all 4 days.
You know, people in Chicago can eat, my friend. You brought enough? You got it all here?
I hope so. I've heard a lot of stories that this line's going to get long here. It's going to get crazy. All the great music acts. I mean, there's so many great things to do here that we'll do what we can.
And you guys are from Austin. You said you've been around for 90 plus years. And if people want to visit you out in Austin, what's the best way for them to find you?
Blacksbbq.com. You know, we got 4 locations all in Central Texas.
Awesome. Well, welcome to Chicago, my friend. Good luck.
Thank you.
All right, that's the Windy City Smokeout here on Chicago's West Side, TBARNAS at WGNTV.com. If you have a suggestion for the Chicago scene, that's TBarnas at WGNTV.com. Have a great weekend, everybody. We'll see you later.